Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to the Institute of Divine Metaphysical Research. This is a school and not a church, and neither are we affiliated with any religious organization. This school is a non-profit, non-denominational, religious, and scientific research organization dedicated to showing proof of the existence of Yahweh, our Elohim, and the operation of His eternal purpose, pattern, and plan operating throughout eternity until this present day. This school was established as a result of a divine vision and revelations given to our founder, Dr. Henry Clifford Kinley, in the state of Ohio in the year of 1931. We were incorporated into the state of California in the year of 1958. Since that time, we have established branch schools throughout the United States and Canada in certain foreign countries. The Ontario branch was established in May of 1988. Now, in this school, we teach by the true and correct names and titles for the Father, the Word, our Son, and the Holy Spirit, as contained in the original Hebrew text. The true and correct name for the Father is Yahweh. And when the scripture translators came across the name of Yahweh, they also inserted the common title, Lord. The true and correct title for the Word, our Son, is Elohim. And when the scripture translators came across the title of Elohim, they wrongly inserted the common title, God. The name of the Holy Spirit, manifest in or out of a physical body, is Yahshua. And when the scripture translators came across the name of Yahshua, they wrongly inserted Jesus Christ. Lord and God are titles and not names. The Apostle Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, tells us in 1 Corinthians 8 and 5 that there are Lords many and Gods many. But we now know each Lord must have a name and each God must have a name also. Elohim is a title. But unlike Lord and God, Elohim is a divine title. This means that Elohim is the title that our Creator chose for Himself. Jesus is a name, but it is an erroneous name. A minor investigation on your part into a good dictionary or encyclopedia will prove that neither the Hebrew language, the Greek language, nor the Latin language have any letters or characters in their alphabet that will produce the sound that is made by this letter J. Neither was there letter J in the English language since 1400 years after the Messiah's death. Therefore, such names as Jesus and Jehovah are impossible renderings for the true and correct name of our Father and His Son. Christ is a title just like Lord and God. Now, Yahweh is pure spirit, and in this state, He is inscrutable and incomprehensible and indiscernible. He is the ultimate source, substance, limits, and bounds of all things. We have Yahweh in His pure spirit state, symbolized on this chart as a fiery cloud. Yahweh in pure spirit is not a cloud. He merely chose a cloud to symbolize Himself, because the cloud has no particular or descriptive shape and form. Just as you see, this fiery cloud has been drawn to extend all around the edges of this chart to show you that everything on this chart abides within this cloud. In like manner, everything in the creation and the sum total of the universe abides within this pure spirit state of Yahweh. Yahweh, knowing that man could not perceive of Him in this pure spirit state, took on shape and form within Himself as Elohim. This is the Word, our Son. A super incorporeal being, that is, having the shape and form of a man, but without flesh and blood. This form can only be seen in divine visions. and understood in divine revelations. Later on, this selfsame spirit manifested himself in a physical body and walked the earth plane as Yahshua the Messiah, whom the world calls Jesus Christ. Now, there's only one name given unto salvation, and we must know that name. So the simple yet intelligent question we should ask ourselves is, what was the name of the Savior during the time he walked the earth plane? A further understanding of this name and title may be had by reading the preface to the Holy Name Bible. Also in this school, we teach by the divine pattern of the universe. It is called the divine pattern because it is Yahweh's pattern. After Yahweh led the children of Israel out of Egypt, he called Moses atop Mount Sinai and showed him the tabernacle pattern in a vision. He instructed Moses to build one exactly like it in the wilderness of Sinai. This pattern consists of a most holy place, a holy place, and a court roundabout. These three compartments make up the one tabernacle pattern. We go forth in this school to show proof of that everything in the universe is made and operates according to the structure and function of this threefold tabernacle pattern, and that absolutely nothing escapes the pattern. The primary constitutional aims and objectives of the Institute are as follows. First, is to help you find and know Yahweh Elohim as he really is and actually exists. Second, is to form a nucleus of universal brotherhood of humanity in Yahshua the Messiah without distinction of race or nationality, creed, sex, caste, or color. Third, is to investigate the unexplained spirit law of the so-called laws of nature and the powers latent in man. Fourth, is to encourage and promote the study of the scriptures, comparative religions, psychology, philosophy, and modern practical and occult science. Fifth, is to extirpate current superstition, skepticism, and ignorance. Sixth, is to learn, know, and understand the operation of Yahweh's eternal purpose through the dispensations and ages. Seventh, is to discern and avoid being deceived by Lucifer, the serpent, the devil, the dragon, or Satan and his demons, operating the mystery of iniquity on earth through the dispensations of time. Eighth, is to earnestly contend for the common salvation and faith, which was once delivered unto the sons or children of Yahweh. Ninth, is to make known that Yahweh, from the beginning, ordained there is no other name given among men whereby a man can be saved, save in the name of Yahshua the Messiah. And tenth, is to inherit eternal life now in the kingdom of Yahshua the Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification in the new earth state. Our watchword is peace, and our slogan is speak the truth. We'll have a prayer this evening by Dr. Samuel Salas, a scripture lesson of Galatians, the third chapter, by Dr. Eric Green.
Good evening, class. Time of prayer. Thank you, Almighty Yahweh, for all the wisdom, understanding you pour into us. We are your true sons. We all have a faithful mind that we know here is the place to learn the truth. Mm-hmm. And thank you for all the good things you give us, mm-hmm. all the blessings, health, and all the things we don't even count it. I say all those things, and you only sign name Yahshua the Messiah. Let's all say
hallelujah.
Thank you.
Good evening, class. Tonight's scripture lesson will be taken from Galatians chapter 3. I'll be reading on page 252 of your Holy Name Bible. I'll be reading from the Holy Name Bible, contained in the Holy Name Version of the Old and New Testaments, critically compared with ancient authorities and various manuscripts, revised by the late A.D. Traynor, the Scripture Research Association Incorporated. Galatians chapter 3. O foolish Galatians, who hath bewitched you, that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Yahshua the Messiah hath been evidently set forth as crucified among you? This only would I learn of you: receive ye the Spirit by the works of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Are ye so foolish? Having begun in the Spirit, are ye now made perfect by the flesh? Have ye suffered so many things in vain, if it be yet in vain? Hear therefore that ministereth to you the Spirit, and worketh miracles among you, doeth he it by the working of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Even as Abraham believed Yahweh, and it was accounted to him for righteousness. Know ye therefore that they which are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham. And the scripture, foreseeing that Yahweh would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, In thee shall all nations be blessed. So then they which be of faith are blessed with faithful Abraham. For as many as are of works of the law are under the curse. For it is written, Cursed is everyone that continueth not in all the things which are written in the book of law to do them. But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of Yahweh, it is evident, for the just shall live by faith. Now the law is not of faith, but the man that doeth these things shall live by them. The Messiah hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, Cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come unto the nations through Yahshua the Messiah, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Brethren, I speak after the manner of men, though it be but a man's covenant, yet if it be confirmed, no man disannulleth or addeth thereto. Now to Abraham and his seed where the promises were made, he said not, and to seeds, plural, but to thy seed, singular, which is his Messiah. And this I say, that the covenant that was confirmed before of Yahweh and his Messiah, the law, which came 430 years after, cannot disannul, that it shall make the promise of none effect. For the inheritance be by the law, it is no more by promise, but Yahweh gave it to Abraham by promise. Wherefore then servereth the law? It was added because of transgressions, to the seed to come to whom the promise was made, and it was ordained by the angels in the hand of a mediator. Now a mediator is not a mediator of one, but Yahweh is one. Is the law then against the promise of Yahweh? By no means, for if there had been a law given which could have given life, verily righteousness should have been by the law. By the scripture hath included all under sin, that promise by faith of Yahshua the Messiah might be given to them that believe. But before faith came, we were kept under the law, set up unto the faith which should afterwards be revealed. Wherefore the law was our schoolmaster, yes, to bring us unto the Messiah, that we might be justified by faith. But after that faith has come, we are no longer under a schoolmaster. For ye are all the children of Yahweh by faith in Yahshua the Messiah. For as many of you as have been immersed in the Messiah have been put on the Messiah. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Yahshua the Messiah. And if ye be the Messiah's, then are ye Abraham's seed and hers according to the promise. I just read Galatians chapter 3.
Our first speaker this evening will be the Dean of the school, Dr. Joe Williams.
Good evening.
Good evening, Joe.
I'm happy to see everyone here. I don't know who picked the scripture off. You picked the scripture, that's it. But it's good because I'm going to go a little bit into that. And I'm going to tell you why. Because we in here, we are Gentiles. Mm-hmm. You see? And the Gentiles did not have the law. Okay? Now let's just pick that up real quick in Romans 2:14, and then it's going to pick up Isaiah 46:9-10. Now the reason why I thought the scripture lesson was good because of my brother Eric came to class tonight. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy to see him. I'm happy to see everybody. But I love that commercial, that television voice, when he reads the scriptures.
Yeah.
He knows how to make those scriptures come alive.
That's right.
But I also want to make sure I put a stamp, you see, on his heart and in his soul, because I want to make sure that he comes on this side of the cross and be a partaker of the gift, you see, of Yahshua Messiah, that it might be formed not only in him, but every last one of us. You see, and what has happened to not only me and to all those out there and everybody in here is that we've been caught up, you see, in this world. You see, and when we get caught up in the world, I'm talking about the flesh. You see, whereby, you see, our minds are corrupt. You see, that we think what's going on in our lives is more important, you see, than learning about Yahweh and his divine purpose. Whether it be your kids, your wife, your family, your school, your job, your house. You follow what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
You see? Well, we do. Look, man, look. I got a little extra something here on my belly. I ain't been no doggone gym. I'm trying to call myself trying to do push-ups every day. Just 10, that's all I can do right now. Every day, but I ain't going any further than that, but I would love to. Nevertheless, you follow what I'm saying? It's about Yahweh and his divine purpose and you coming to that profound understanding of, listen, who you are. Mm-hmm. You see, not him, but who you are. And I'm not out here trying to save souls. I want to make that real clear. Mm-hmm. You see, there's only one soul that I'm capable of saving or even having a chance. You know who that might be? This one right here. And so can you. In other words, if you see Yahweh in him, but you can't see it in you, then what the hell are you doing down here?
Right.
You're not discerning the body. Mm-hmm. You see, we want you to find out who you are so that you can take the veil of the flesh off and realize what spirit is operating in you. And when you can identify that, you see, then and only then is the Messiah being formed in you.
Right.
We can turn this down just a little bit. Just a little bit. I gotta make some adjustments or it should be real easy. Yeah, you got the gain down?
Yeah.
Good. Not too far though.
No.
Now, yeah, it's too far down. Now, with that being said, yeah, you turn that off too far. This chart, which we call the map chart, right? Mm-hmm. It says proving the existence and the structure of Satan and his angels through the dispensations and ages. How is that going to benefit me? Do you understand what I'm saying? Proving the existence and destruction of Satan and his angel through the dispensations and ages. Well, first of all, we got to identify who Satan is. If you can't identify who he is, you see, he can just creep on you and creep up on you anytime he gets ready. Especially if you have a concept about who the devil is or who Satan is, or and especially if you don't know what angels are.
Right.
Now we can pray all we want and be sincere, But the question is, your mind has to be renewed through knowledge. Mm-hmm. We're going to pick that up in a minute. Ephesians 4:22, and just hit Romans. I think I called Isaiah 46:9-10. Did I not?
Yes.
Let's move, please.
Which one?
Isaiah 46:9-10. Why? Because I want to declare that Yahweh has a purpose. Mm-hmm. And he has a pattern and a plan that is in operation. Whereby, we as men are not conscious of that purpose. That purpose has to be revealed to us by his son, Yahshua the Messiah. Mm-hmm. Who is within us. Mm-hmm. But we're not conscious of that. We still think that we are this egotistical, misdirected personality, and please don't insult me that way. You see? Because you don't want to think that. Mm-hmm. You see? Because that's like a slap in the face, like a low blow. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been watching the candidates, the debates.
Yeah.
They go at each other, attacking each other's character when they're both the same.
Yeah.
And they both at fault.
Yeah.
Right.
And they just as fault as everybody who's going to vote for them, they all at fault as well. Mm-hmm. You see? But they want to figure out which fault they want to hang on to. You follow what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But the point is, they still are caught up in this amalgamation or conglomeration, you see, of a Corey mass. In other words, what I'm trying to get, this composite of a man. Mm-hmm. You see, every thought that you have, every sentence, every paragraph, you see, that makes you up. What your parents, your priest, your rabbi, your education, whatever it is, your new house, your new car, whatever you embrace, this is it. It's the world. You see, perfumes, wealth, politics, this is it. Family, friends, whatever, this is it. Everybody with me so far?
Yeah.
This shape and form, or this composite of a man, or this matrix, if you will, you see, is corrupt. However, it's so powerful, it can attract our minds off the very thing that we love. And that is Yahweh himself. We love Yahweh, but the world controls our movements by way of the flesh, and you're not even conscious of it, that you're operating, you see, by the flesh, mm-hmm. you see, which is opposite of spirit law. You see, now, Yahweh set this thing up. We got up here, it says vision, it's the Ahaz chart. You see, and it's showing that Yahweh is running both mysteries. The mystery of righteousness and the mystery of unrighteousness.
That's right.
You with me so far?
Yeah.
Don't miss this.
Uh-uh.
You are a miniature construction of the universe. Meaning, you have a spirit man operating, but you also have the flesh operating. And when I say flesh, I ain't talking about this. That's the problem. We can't discern the body. When I say flesh, they think I'm talking about a physical body. If that be the case, there's a whole lot of physical bodies laying dead, they ain't acting the way we acting. We're talking about this man, you see, that's buffeting us, talking to us, you see, causing us to do things we ain't got no business, or moving in a direction we know better. Everybody with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking this home tonight. Why? Because there's a purpose in operation. And I'm telling you, like it or not, the mystery of righteousness and the mystery of unrighteousness. But it is Yahweh who's controlling both mysteries.
Yeah.
That's the point I'm trying to get you to see. He's controlling both mysteries.
Yeah. That's right.
You see? Now, this says vision. You see? And it's going this way. You see? And it's going his way. Showing how that Yahweh Elohim transforms into a tabernacle. This is the definition. You with me?
Yeah.
Oh, this spirit man right here with this Yahweh himself. You see? Then you have him over here setting up a delusion or the mystery of unrighteousness. There's a tabernacle and there's a woman. There's a woman. She's the bride of him. He's the only husband there is. Ain't no five, six husbands. Ain't but one. You know,
mm-hmm.
your wife or your husband is just a schoolmaster, just a type of the shadow. Because at the end of the day, your husband or your wife can't save you.
Right.
You follow me? But the spirit that's in your husband or your wife can. So here you are, manifesting the mystery of unrighteousness, which is corrupt. Because this man here, you see, we're giving all the praise and the homage to the flesh, if you will. Now, you are a threefold universal spirit parent with an immutable spirit law abiding within you. That's who you are and what you are where you sit. Our goal is to inherit eternal life right now in the kingdom of Yahshua Messiah with the hope of immortal glorification. That's what we're after. All right? Now read Isaiah. Now we're way back, you see, under the dispensation of the law, and we're reading about what Isaiah said. Now when I say under the dispensation of the law, remember, Abraham was given the promise. We read that in the scripture lesson.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You see, and Yahweh made a promise to Abraham that in his seed, singular, because you know he had a couple of kids. He had a lot. He had about eight, maybe nine kids. He had eight, maybe one, I think he had 10 kids. Because he had two by, he had one by Sarah, one by her handmaid, but then he had another wife, Keturah, and he had eight kids with her. Is that right, Doc?
Yeah, six.
Okay. How much is that? That's 10, right? Yeah. My point is, it's his seed. Mm-hmm. His deposits, if you will. But you understand that. Mm-hmm. Now, here we got Abraham, who received the promise. But none of them was the seed of promise. Right. Now, here come Abraham, who was under the dispensation of faith, mm-hmm. not the dispensation of the law. Mm-hmm. You see, why? Because Moses, you see, who was given the law, had not yet been born. He was still in Abraham's loins. Mm-hmm. You with me so far?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And the law had not been yet given. Mm-hmm. Nevertheless, the seed, the promise was unto Abraham, his seed. So here he comes, you see, according to a purpose, Yahweh made a promise to Abraham. Now read.
Isaiah 46 and 9.
Yes, please.
Remember the former things of old.
Read on.
For I am El.
Read on.
And there is none else.
So I am Elohim. And there is none else.
I am Elohim, and there is none like me.
I am Elohim, and there is none like me. Why? Read on.
Declaring the end.
I declare the end. You follow me? Right from the beginning. In other words, it is me, Yahweh, who is the ultimate source, the substance, the limit, the bounds, the origin, and the essence of all things. Who declare what shall be? Way back here in the realm of eternity, or in a pure spirit, or in an abstract state. Talking about Yahweh, the Father, the source and the substance of all things. Back here. He declared that. He is equipped, you follow me, to give birth to his Son. Being made up of these attributes of intelligence, wisdom, and knowledge, beauty, love, justice, foundation, power, and strength. That is his divine makeup. Talking about Yahweh. That makes him the parent of substance. So it behooved him, according to a purpose that is, that he come into a state whereby him being the creator, he created a creation, and then he creates a creature. Mm-hmm. But then it is Yahweh Elohim, who is in shape and form, or Elohim, who is the archetype or the original pattern of the universe. Listen, you see, I'll say it like this. In other words, he creates a purpose according to what Yahweh declared.
Yeah.
In other words, Yahweh declared what shall be.
Yeah.
Then Yahweh Elohim takes on shape and form. You see, or Yahweh give birth to his son as Yahweh Elohim. You see, then Yahweh Elohim in his creative state, you see, transform or transmute or transfigure into every cosmographical structure of the universe, including you. Don't want to leave you out. You see? So therefore, when Elohim steps out of this cloud, I'll take those two charts on the end, one and two. Just put them right over there. When Yahweh Elohim steps out of the cloud, you see, Elohim is, listen, an execution of the purpose. He is just coming on out and he's moving and bringing that purpose on down. In this state, I'm talking about in his pure spirit state or in his abstract state, this is Yahweh in his ontological state of perfection, if you will. Just put it right there. You see? And put two there. I appreciate that. This is him in his ideological state of a perfection. But this shape and form and that shape and form, they're one of the shapes, one of the self-same. Mm-hmm. You see? And listen, it's on the chart right here. Elohim is being flanked by who is intelligence, wisdom, and knowledge, which makes up the crown. Mm-hmm. You see? Beauty, love, and justice making up the chest region. You see? And then foundation, power, and strength. That all makes up his body. But as him, he's coming from behind the veil of inscrutability. You see, as his son, or Yahweh himself, doing business as Yahweh Elohim. If that makes any sense.
Yeah.
So now, he's in his creative state, and the book said, we read in Dr. Kennedy's pamphlet, that when Yahweh created Elohim, that Yahweh the Father went out of the creating business. But now it's the son that's going to do the work. Now the son is set up to carry out the will of the Father.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. See, this is Yahweh in his rest. Or in the Sabbath, if you will. Mm-hmm. But now this is him in his work clothes. You see, now he's going to set this thing in motion. Why? Because I declared it. Now Yahweh on him as a declaration of what I declare. Yeah. In other words, the purpose moved from one state condition to an incorporeal state condition. And then he put a stamp on it. He transfigured into a tabernacle, having nine furnishings to witness to these nine divine attributes, because he knew that the man himself was not going to understand Yahweh Elohim or understand these divine attributes. He knew that. So he made provisions in the purpose, you see, before he set Elohim forth. Or you follow what I'm saying? So when he moved, you have no excuse why you should not know your creator as he really is and as he actually exists. Mm-hmm. You see? So now we got Yahweh Elohim, who is the archetype for the original pattern of the universe. Yeah. He set up, you see, from everlasting. Oh, there's so much. Keep reading. And while you're at it, pick up Proverbs 8:22. And hold that for me, please.
Declaring the end from the beginning.
He declared the end right from the beginning. Now let me say this before anybody get misunderstand. This shape and form here, which is Yahweh Elohim, who is clothed upon, and this one right here, alright, they're one and the self same. Mm-hmm. There is no difference. Absolutely zero difference. Somebody said, well, he's naked here. He's never naked. Yahweh Elohim has never been naked. Some folks say, well, he don't look like he got no clothes on here. For first of all, he ain't got, he's both masculine and feminine, yet neither. He does not have any genitalia of any sort. Hand or position. In the groin area, you follow, that's not how he is. Nevertheless, he's both masculine and feminine within himself, yet neither. Being this great, heavenly, anthropomorphic being. Having the tools and equipped to give birth to virgin mother, including you. Talking about Yahweh and his purpose. Alright? Let's read. But my point is, this is him clothed upon. And this is him, you see, he's hidden. Meaning that you don't know, in other words, these, when he transforms to the tabernacle, these are curtains. Me and my dumb so-and-so back in the day, I thought these were socks down here. That's what I thought they was laid with socks on, because that's what it looked like. Remember the Globetrotters? Because he got white, it's blue purple scar, but that's what I thought. You see, because they looked like a man with socks on and his feet. That's what I thought. Then I found out later, this is the tabernacle, because I see the labor. You see, and all the sin sacrifice. You see, and I didn't think this orange was a veil. But they told me what it was. But I still thought it was a man with socks off. But the point is, he's hidden. That's what this representation of. Mm-hmm. Talking about Yahweh Elohim with the book in his hand. Mm-hmm. Then when he transformed into this tabernacle here, you would be so far.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You see, this is him, you see, or an explanation of the word. Or the word of words. Or the mystery of mystery. The soul of soul. The men of men. It is the account within him. That's what the book is all about.
Yeah.
You see? So now we got him set up. And I'll say it like this. Here's Yahweh. You see, pure spirit. Then he appears within the cloud, standing on the earth. That is Yahweh Elohim, as the founder said, he's a whole brass band all by himself. Carrying out the will of the Father. But when he appears within the cloud, he's come from behind the veil of inscrutability or from that sixth or that second departmental veil. He's just stepping on out. And when he comes out before that, that was angelic invisibility. Now this is angelic visibility. You guys with me so far? We can see him. But we still don't know nothing about him. So what he does, he transfigure into every cosmic phase of the creation, including the man. But that was declared way back here in the realm of eternity, but it was set motion when he came from out of the cloud. You with me so far? And listen, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Now, let's not be carnal now and think that Yahweh have a book in his hand. It's a pictorial illustration to show you that he himself, he is the book. And you are the witness. Within that boy right there is his children, their children, their children, and their children. And they all have names. We just haven't named them yet. But that makes him the books. He is the books, and we are the books. Everybody with me so far? So we can tell that by the way you walk, what's written in your book. If you walk with a swag, you know what I mean? We know what's in the book. You see? You get the point, because this is the Institute of Divine what? Metaphysical research. We see this is just the type of the shadow, the schoolmaster. To lead us, we'll do it this way. To lead us to the Messiah. So we know it's operating in you by the way you walk and how you manifest your actions. By power and demonstration, we know. Nevertheless, here he is. Keep reading, please. Declaring the end from the beginning. I ain't getting there yet. My point is, this is not linear. You get my point? It's a round circle. This is a circle. It just looks like a linear. It's just a pit. But you know how you run a track, you go around, the same one, but when you come back with the prize, yay! You feel what I'm saying? But you know what? And then they start putting the medals and all that stuff on, and you put your clothes on, you go and do your commercial and go to Disneyland. That's what this is right here. The difference is, he's already in Disneyland. He's the creator of Disneyland, or the source of substance of Disney. Disney ain't got no... Look, Disney name is written in the book, and he ain't got no thoughts of his own. Every thought that he had came from the boss himself. Whatever you thought, whatever you think or even conceive in your mind, it all comes from him. Way back here, how he declared it and set it up. You with me so far? Let's read so I can get through this, because I ain't got nowhere. Read.
And from ancient times, the things that are not yet done.
Read on.
Saying, my counsel shall stand.
In other words, whatever I have is in the realm of eternity. When it's set in motion, I can't change it. Yahweh put the sun in the heaven on the fourth day to illuminate the entire universe. You see? But prior to that, it was Yahweh unto himself. You see, who controlled light, who was that cosmic light illuminating the way. You with me so far? But when he put the sun in the heavens on the fourth day, he gave way to the light and allowed the light to illuminate the universe. If he did not do that, he would not be a just Ael.
That's right.
He had to be obedient to his own law. So when folks come at me talking like, well, in the garden, if I'm Yahweh Elohim, it's my God, I can do whatever I want. I don't think so. You can't do whatever you want. You see, because I am the law. And when the woman was drawn out, she was already in transgression. You see, and if I'm calling the shots, I can do, no. It's my house, it's my yard. If I tell you, I'm coming on there, you with it, and I can shoot. No, it don't work like that. Because even the law is subject to the law. That's the point I'm trying to make. Even the police officer today, people say, well, the police, they can run a red light, but you can't. Yeah, they can run a red light, but they better not hit no damn body either. Let them hit somebody, I guarantee you they shove the subject to the law. You see, because Yahweh don't operate without laws and witnesses. You see, Let me get through this. Come on, read, please.
And I will do all my pledge.
I'm going to do all that I purpose and that I cleared in the realm of eternity. Come on, read.
That's it. Did you want to go to Proverbs?
No. Go ahead, read on
11.
Calling the eagle.
Calling the eagle.
Okay, calling the eagle.
Now, who's the east? This is him right here. That's Yahweh Elohim. What? Because there was Yahweh Elohim within Yahshua Messiah. Remember, Yahweh Elohim is the mind of Yahshua Messiah. It's the word made flesh, causing the eagle. That's why that E is in that title. Calling the eagle from the E. Oh, this thing is tight. Let's read. The man
that executed my counsel.
So we ain't talking about no doggone bird. Right. Don't make that real clear. Mm-hmm. You say, oh, the eagle from the east. No, we ain't talking about no damn bird. Read, please.
Yea, I have spoken it.
That's what the lips all about. Mm-hmm. You see, I've spoken it, because Yahweh spoke it, and boom, thus it was. Mm-hmm. Since you there, keep reading.
I will also bring it to pass.
Pick up, I think it's Proverbs 33 and 9. If it ain't Proverbs, it's Psalm 33 and 9, but I think it's Proverbs. I purpose it right.
Yes.
And I will also bring it to pass. Whatever I purpose and whatever I declare. When Elohim stepped out of that cloud, he was the execution of what Yahweh declared, or he was the declaration of the purpose. So therefore, he can't change anything. And see, if you just want to use that terminology, he reached back. He reached back in the vat that he declared and brought it forth, and that's it. Because Yahweh Elohim, he is the standard of righteousness. You with me so far? Let's read, please. Isaiah, I think it's Proverbs 33 and 9. You can start at 6 if you want to.
Psalms.
Is it Psalm 33 and 9?
Yeah.
Then start at 6 then.
From Psalms 33 and 6.
I'm going to stay quiet.
By the word of Yahweh mm-hmm. were the heavens made.
Here it is. Go ahead, Doc.
And all the host of them by the breath of his mouth.
Read on.
He gathereth the waters of the sea mm-hmm. together as in heat.
Read on.
He layeth up the depth in storehouses. Let all the earth fear Yahweh.
Read on.
Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him.
Come on.
For he spake and it was done.
Look, he spake and it was done. No words. How you do? He just willed it. Mm-hmm. No audible sound. And it was done. Read on.
He commanded.
He commanded.
And it stood fast.
Here we are. You see? Mm-hmm. Now everybody here is not here by accident. I know sometimes people seem like that way. It ain't no accident. Mm-hmm. It just did not, sometimes it did not conform with your carnal mind. Mm-hmm. And you get this so-called, I said so-called, oops. Mm-hmm. Ain't no oops. Mm-hmm. It was already purposed, it was already declared. This is the oops right here. I didn't mean that. No, you meant that. It's just that your mind is corrupt. Mm-hmm. I know that's rough, mm-hmm. but it is. Somebody's like, oh, it's corrupt. I'm getting there. All right?
Uh-huh.
Now, finish that up, Doc.
He spake and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast.
That's good enough right there. I just want to show how Yahweh, you know, you have lightning and you have thunder, right? Mm-hmm. In other words, he spoke it, here comes the lightning. Now the sign follows. Mm-hmm. Why? Because we got the law and the prophets. See, whatever is written in the law is confirmed by the prophets. Whatever in the prophets is confirmed by the law. That's what they call Yahweh of hosts. His two faithful witnesses. That's what that's all about. Yahweh is pure spirit in two manifestations. Incorporeal and corporeal. It's just that simple. Two faithful witnesses. Incorporeal, visible. Incorporeal, invisible, and visible. I can't say it no plainer than that. All right? Everybody with me so far?
Yeah.
Now, let's read the next scripture. Proverbs 22 and 8.
Proverbs 22 and 8.
Read on.
Yahweh possessed.
I'm trying to get someplace, but I'm trying to set the groundwork. See, if I set the groundwork, the point is, I'm trying to tear off some of that damn flesh. I'm trying to take off that flesh. Mm-hmm. You know?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
In other words, foreplay, if you will. Mm-hmm. Some people just got to get ready.
Got to get located.
That too. Mm-hmm. But your mind got to be right.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You get the point?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go.
Yahweh possessed me in the beginning of his way.
Now hold it. Yahweh possessed, listen. Me.
Right.
Me. See, this was linear. Yahweh possessed me. And I'll say it like this. Oh, man, there's so much. Oh, there's just so much. You see, you got the male, right? I do it like this. You got the male, and you got the female. Everybody with me so far.
Mm-hmm.
But when they come together, you follow what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
He plants a seed. You follow me? She has the egg.
Mm-hmm.
So, you got her, I'll do it this way. You got her who's housed with the eggs. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you like it is, she only got so many.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She ain't got like you got. You got millions.
Mm-hmm.
Not 1, 2, 3 million. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about 60 million on every ejaculate. You feeling me now?
Mm-hmm.
A whole bunch. You see, soldiers, if you will, trying to get to that egg.
Mm-hmm.
You with me so far?
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you right now, they're running like hell. You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Swim it upstream. They're swimming upstream. You follow me? Trying to get to that egg.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Sitting there waiting.
Mm-hmm.
You see? But it's the male that dropped that seed.
Yeah.
Now some of them die off. You follow me?
Mm-hmm.
But there's only going to be one that's going to pierce that veil.
Yeah.
And when that seed pierced that veil, you follow me? That's what we call a zygote. A zygote. Or a zygote.
Zygote.
Z-O-G. I spelled that wrong. Z. Y. O.
T.
T. E. There's a G in there somewhere. A zygote.
I think it's
Z-Y-G-T-O-E. Yeah, zygote. You see? Now you got a fertilized egg.
Okay.
That tail falls off. Because that tail is a type of satanic spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Because like it's drawing a tail. See, that one hits.
Yeah.
But that tail falls because Lucifer drew one-third.
Mm-hmm.
His tail drew one-third.
Mm-hmm.
You see, of the angels.
Mm-hmm.
So he falls off. So now you got a living cell,
mm-hmm.
or an ovum,
mm-hmm.
or a zygote. Because that's the ovum. You with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
So now, what I'm trying to get you to see, that when that seed pierced that egg, or that ovum, you see, it is Yahweh Elohim, or it is spirit. Law. That is animating that seed,
mm-hmm.
or animating that zygote, or animating that fertilization, causing it to live and move and has its being, even though you are not conscious of it.
Mm-hmm.
You see, why? That is your hope. You understand? That seed is your hope. Your hope that you can make it through that journey, that 9 months,
mm-hmm.
you see, and be birthed into this,
yeah.
and learn of your Creator. How glorious is that? Even the angels desire to know who this is, because they did not know him as Yahshua. They knew him as Elohim, but not as Yahshua. That had to be. He was just like any other Joe Blow up in here, talking about Yahshua Messiah. Talking about Elohim among the angels. You couldn't tell one from the other.
Yeah.
Until he got out of line. Which I'm trying to get to. You see? You with me so far? But my point is, here you are. Same way. And listen, now you're going to take 9 months to take on shape and form.
Mm-hmm.
40 weeks. Just as Adam was in that garden for 40 days. Just as Abraham's seed that went down to the land of Egypt. And after 3 days journey, just like this, a 3 days journey to the third day, the seed of vegetation coming on up. So here come Abraham's seed coming on up, or resurrecting into the wilderness here. You follow me?
Mm-hmm.
Yahweh carried out his purpose, listen, through the man. That's what he's doing. Because that's where the purpose is. You see, that's where spirit law is, that's where Yahshua is, that's where heaven is, that's where the kingdom is. Mm-hmm. Contrary to what everybody's telling you. Mm-hmm. But see, this old boy right here, talking about Lucifer, I need to get him up here. You see, what he did, he got you looking at the world. You see, he got you looking at all the wealth and the money and the stocks. He got you looking at the world. Mm-hmm. Got you caught up in turmoil. That's what he does. That's his job. That's his mission. To confuse you. Have you tossed to and fro. Should I make? You already know what to do and what not to do. You get my point? Nevertheless, Yahweh running his show, carrying his purpose through the man. Read, please.
Yahweh possessed me in the beginning of his way.
Now look, Yahweh possessed me. Elohim, I'll say it like this. In the beginning of his way. In other words, read on, Doc.
Before his work.
Before all this came on in. Before this came in. Before you got here. You was in your mama's womb. Taking on shape and form. And before you even came together, you existed because your name was written in the book. You just didn't know your name was in the book. I don't care what your name is. It's in the book. But here you got Yahweh carrying out his purpose through the man. And I'll do it like this. Read, please.
I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning or ever the earth was. When there were no depths, I was brought forth.
When there was no depths. No water. You see, this is Adam. All right? Everybody with me so far? You see, here's Elohim. All right? Here come the man. All right? We'll just call him Adam. You can call him whatever your name is, too. But you get the point. You see, then Yahweh, you see, I'll do it like this. As you're taking on shape and form in your mother's womb, that's you.
Yeah.
And after 40 weeks, you're going to get a bouncing baby boy or a girl. Mm-hmm. With me so far? That's what we're going to get. But it has to be after 40 weeks. Mm-hmm. Why? Because Adam comes out of that garden after 40 days. You follow me? Israel had to come up out of the wilderness after 40 years. You follow me? Noah, after 40 days, they could come out, but they had to, you follow what I'm saying? It's not, they can, it just wasn't safe to come out. They can go out there and swim in the ocean if they want to. Take a dip, a little recreation. You see, but they got to climb through the window. They can't come out through the door. Because Yahweh closed the door, Yahweh, but you get the point? You see? So when I'm trying to get to the city, it's after 40, the principle of 40 that's being here. You see? Let's read, please.
When there was no fountains abounding with water.
Go ahead.
Before the mountains were settled.
Read on.
Before the hills was I brought.
Come on, Doc. Read on.
While as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world.
Read on.
When he prepared the heavens, I was there. When he set a compass upon the face of the depth.
Now, that's Yahweh Elohim saying he was there. Not Solomon.
Yeah.
Right.
It was him. Before the everlasting. Before the world was settled. I was here. That's him right there. Because it was him in his creative state or in his I will be state whereby he assembled the creation by the pattern of himself.
That's right.
You with me so far? Now he set it up. We got the man Adam and he has no fault at this particular time. Alright? Plate 14. Let me have it real quick. Now, with that being said, when Yahweh created creation, I'm letting you know, Lucifer did not see it. And let me say it a different way. He saw it, but he didn't understand how it was done. He does not have permission to create a body. He does not.
Right.
We don't have permission to create a body. We know that we have them. We just don't know how the hell it's done. Mm-hmm. Isn't that right? Oh, we know about anatomy and physiology and how what's going on within it. But we can't create one and put a spirit in it. You do not have permission. Not from Yahweh, you don't. Now, you might make something look almost like a man by grabbing parts together. Isn't that what I'm talking about? I'm talking about from the cellular level. You follow what I'm saying? From the cellular level. You follow what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When one cell becomes two cells become four cells. You follow what I'm saying? You get my point?
Mm-hmm.
Four cells become eight cells. Eight cells become 16. 16 become 32, and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. You get my point?
Mm-hmm.
But it all made up from that. You can't do that.
Yeah.
You don't have permission. And neither does Lucifer. Because he's in the same state condition you in. He's just about as carnal as you are. And corrupt. Somebody said, yeah, corrupt. You see? But I'm letting you know right here. This seed coming in, that ain't corrupt. Better throw that out right there. But somebody said, oh, you mean that? No, that ain't corrupt. Spirit law, taking on shape and form, that ain't corrupt.
Mm-hmm.
That soul have not done nothing to nobody. You with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
Now, picking up Abraham's seed. Now, go back to the scripture lesson and pick up Romans 8 and, so before we get that, go real quick to Ephesians 1 and 9. Then head to Galatians, I think I call it Romans 2:14, I ain't never got to yet. There, and then we head where I want to go. Let's read, please. Remember, it is Yahweh that's running the show through his son. And everything is within him. Oh man, there's so much. Y'all got a textbook still, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Pick it up and just hold page 50, volume 1. Second paragraph. Maybe
what was
third.
It Ephesians?
Ephesians 1 and 9, please.
Ephesians 1 and 9.
Now this is after his death, his burial, his resurrection, and ascension, and outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And this is what the Apostle Paul says in this present kingdom age. All right? Let's read, please.
Heaven made known unto us.
Heaven made known unto me and unto you and anybody else walking on the sun. Heaven made known unto us. In other words, the mystery has been unlocked.
Yeah.
The veils and the curtains have been taken off. So there's no excuse why you should not know your Creator, because Yahweh set it up for you to know. Let's read, Doc.
According to his good pleasure.
According to his good pleasure, what he purposed back here in the realm of eternity. Let's read.
Which he purposed himself.
Which he purposed within himself. Come on, let's read.
That in the dispensation of the fullness of time.
That in the dispensation of the fullness of time.
He might gather together in one all things in the Messiah.
He didn't say some things. He gonna gather together all things. Mm-hmm. Not some things. Mm-hmm. All things. Not some. All means all. Ain't nothing left out. Into his son. Read on, please.
Both which are in heaven.
Those which are in heaven and those which are on earth.
Even in him.
Even in him. Now, this is what I want to talk about. Don't get stuck on this flesh right here.
Mm-hmm.
This is a weather-beaten tabernacle.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't believe it, just take a good look at yourself. This is a weather-beaten tabernacle. Talk about this one that was built out of the wood. That's a weather-beaten tabernacle. But this one out here, talk about Solomon's temple. That's a glorious tabernacle. That's a glorious sanctuary. It's a type and a shadow of Yahweh Elohim. and that it is a permanent structure, it is a permanent fix. You see, because what they did was, they took the articles that was in the tabernacle and they placed them in Solomon's temple. You see, that's what they did. Because it's a type of mortality putting on immortality. Corruption putting on incorruption. So, Paul says it like this, wherefore henceforth know ye no man after the flesh. Don't even know the Messiah after the flesh. Henceforth know ye know we him no more after the flesh. Now we can have that read if you want to. 2 Corinthians 5:16. Because this is the problem. This is what I'm after tonight. You have to discern the bodies. So while folks run around here with a cross on their neck, got Jesus all spread out like this here, crying out like a damn fool, because he died, you better be glad he died.
That's right.
And rejoice that he died.
Yeah.
You see, don't be sad about it. Be happy that he got on that cross and atone for your sins.
That's right.
The question is, when you going to get up on the cross? And the cross I'm talking about getting up on is this one right here. Everybody here got one of these, don't you? Question is, what are you waiting on? That's the sternum. That's the clavicle. Everybody's wearing one of these cards hanging right on you. And everybody, look, everybody got one of these. 33, come right on down. That's the minute, points to the Messiah. You see, when are you going to make a sacrifice? Read, please. Wherefore, henceforth. Go ahead. 2 Corinthians 5:16. I think that's where it is. I'm pretty sure about it right now. That's exactly where it is.
2 Corinthians 5:16. Wherefore, henceforth, know we no man after the flesh.
Read on.
Yea, though we have known the Messiah.
Even though we know him after the flesh. Read on.
After the flesh, yet now henceforth know we him no more.
It didn't say later. It said now. Henceforth, from going forth.
Right
now. Don't even know the Messiah after the flesh. Come on, read.
Therefore, if any man be in the Messiah.
If any man be in Yahshua Messiah. He ain't talking about this physical body. Don't know him after the flesh. We're going to be in this body right here. Read on. Yahweh Elohim. Read on.
He is a new creature.
He is a new creature because you know what? Now, this man right here got some clothes on. He has some clothes on. He's a new creature. You see? Hope. Stay right there. Go back to the first verse. But don't leave that spot because I need that spot. Read on, please.
2 Corinthians 5:1.
Read on.
For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved,
this physical body,
we have a building of Elohim.
We have a building of Elohim, which is your spirit man or your spirit body.
A house not made with hands.
A house not made with hands. Now you know good well that spirit within you was not made with hands, neither was that physical body made with hands, right?
Right.
Let's read on, please.
Eternal in heaven.
That's fixed eternal in heaven. That is, if this physical body be dissolved, you see, there's another one that is pitched eternal in heaven, which is Yahweh Elohim. I'm letting you know, you're going to get your immortal body right out of the old one. Ain't no other way. It ain't coming from someplace. You're going to get your new immortal body right out of the old one. That's the only place, right out of the old one. That's the only place you can get it from. Why? Because that's where Yahshua is. He's in the realm of church. He's in heaven. And heaven is here. The problem is that we've been deceived. This thing right here, I'm talking about this one right here. As corrupted as it is, that's the deception. The point is, what's bothering you, is messing you up, is your theories, your concepts, and opinion, your thought process. That's this man right here. It's just that you need a physical body to operate in. Ooh, so much. I'm going to get that in a minute. Keep reading, please. Come on.
For in this we groan.
For in this we groan. Talk about us in this age. We groan. Read on.
Earnestly desire.
What we groan for? We groan for. We groan for what?
Desiring to be clothed.
Be clothed. What, with some fruit of the looms? Some pampers? Some shine pink comb clothes? Levi's? I don't think so. Wranglers? They got to get the cowboys. We ain't what we call the one with that. No. We want some knowledge and some understanding about our Creator. That's what we want to be clothed upon with.
Right.
Those are our clothes. We just got him having clothes on so you'll understand how glorious he is. But when you have a knowledge, man, can't nobody touch you.
Right.
Can't nobody put their hands on you. They can't touch you because you're knowledgeable. They can make a bunch of noise, but they can't touch what you say. Yeah. Read, please. That's what we got down here. The truth. Read, please. Come on.
If so be that being clothed.
If so be being clothed on with Yahshua Messiah, with intelligence, wisdom, knowledge, beauty, love, justice, foundation, power, and strength. Read.
We shall not be found naked.
You ain't gonna fuck. Because naked. Exposed. You know why? Because you know what the hell you're talking about.
Yeah.
Lent came up the other day. I'm talking Wednesday. I couldn't even get when I left work, man. I couldn't even get out. All these damn cars over at a Catholic church. And I saw these folks walking out with this cross. I said, oh, no wonder. Today's Lent. February 10th. 46 days prior to the resurrection of the Messiah. Because, you know, the Messiah said, he was looking at the Herodian temple. He says, this temple being 46 years in the building, right? He says, thou will raise it up in 3 days. So they thought, how are you going to raise up the temple in 3 days? Mm-hmm. He was never talking about the temple. He was talking about his body. Mm-hmm. And John let the cat out. He said, this is the key of his body. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't this weather-beaten tabernacle.
Right.
It wasn't his physical body.
Right.
It was his spirit body. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm trying to get you to see. It's the spirit body. Christianity got him raising a physical body. The book says he resurrected a quickened spirit. So wherefore know ye no where you know wherefore henceforth know ye no man after the flesh. Don't even know the Messiah after the flesh.
Yeah.
You see? Is that called scripture?
Ephesians 9 and 1. Ephesians 1 and 9.
Oh no, keep reading where you left off at.
For we that are in this tabernacle do groan.
Now that's up. In this this physical body. Now look, folks, you wouldn't even know that you were threefold. And what I mean by that, you would never know that you're made spirit, soul, and body unless you had a head, chest, and abdominal region. Can I say that again? You would not have no clue that Yahweh is even threefold unless you had a head, chest, and abdominal region. Mm-hmm. Let alone a body, a spirit, a soul, and a body. Because the man is threefold because Yahweh, the Father, or the supernal nature, or the Godhead is threefold. Father, Word, and Holy Spirit, these three are one. That's the only reason you know that, because he gave you one. Mm-hmm. To witness to him. This man is a witness to this man right here. Talking about Yahweh Elohim himself. Mm-hmm. Without him, talking about Yahweh Elohim, there is no you. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it is him in you. You see, by way of these attributes, mm-hmm. that is leading you to him. Mm-hmm. Talking about Yahweh Elohim. Mm-hmm. And listen, in reality, this is the bizarre, there's so much. See, this shape and form of a man mm-hmm. is the image that Yahweh showed you for you to understand this organized set of attributes.
Yeah.
But listen, let's get one thing straight. This is an organized set of attributes, mm-hmm. you see, which is spirit. And the arrangement of those attributes, that is his body. You hear what I said? Those arrangements, that is his body. And each one of those attributes, no matter what you like it, that is spirit law. The spirit, it's the makeup of spirit. Mm-hmm. And encapsulated within these attributes, or the makeup, is the entire purpose and plan of Yahweh from start to finish. I'm talking about in each one of these attributes, and in each day of creation is the entire purpose of Yahweh, plan of Yahweh from start to finish. Because if you know one plate, you know them all. It's just that simple. I can't say it no other kind of way. Let's read, please.
For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon the mortality might be swallowed up of life.
Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. That mortality, corruption, theories, concepts, and opinions might be swallowed up. Of what?
Of life.
Yahweh Elohim. I am the way, the truth, and the life. In the beginning was the Word, right? The Word was with Yahweh, and the Word was Yahweh. All things was made by the Word. It was not anything made that was made. In Him, talking about Yahweh Elohim, was what? Life. And the life was what?
The light,
or the illumination, or the understanding of mankind. Can't you see that the purpose, when it came down, that the purpose now encouched within the man or within you? Wake up! That's how it is. I can't say it no other way. Now somebody said, well, I disagree, and that's all you better do, is disagree. But can you prove? Can you show me something else that you might save me so that I can come on your team? You see? That's just how it is. Read, please.
Now he that hath wrought us for...
That's good enough right there. Now I got to head back. Now listen, this ain't nothing new. See, the children of Israel, they were a stiff-necked and uncircumcised people. But let me get this in before I move on. I want the 32nd chapter of Exodus, but I also want Romans 2 and 10. I mean 2:14, because I got to get this out. I'm dragging. Let's read. And I need the promise.
Romans 2:14.
Exodus 32:1. Just hold that for me.
On Romans now?
Yes, please.
Romans 2:14.
I've been trying to get to it for a whole hour. My goodness. Read on, please.
For when the Gentiles, which have not the law...
Now the Gentiles, which is us, we already talked about this other... Gentiles is anyone that's not a physical, natural Jew.
Right.
Jew.
Right.
By birth. That's what a Gentile is. Anyone that is outside of that physical genealogy. You see, or lineage. A physical Jew. Oh, one of Abraham's sons. Read, please.
Do by nature the things contained in the law.
Now the Gentiles do by nature the things contained within the law. Read on.
These, having not the law.
In other words, they did not have the tabernacle pattern.
Are a law unto themselves.
They are a law to themselves. In other words, go ahead, read on.
Which show the work of the law written in their hearts. Their conscience also bearing witness, and their thoughts the meanwhile accusing or else excusing one another.
Now that's because, see, sitting on your throne or in your green and white matter is Yahweh Elohim. It is Him that is made manifest when you feel guilty. That is Him or the Holy Spirit that is being made known to you on the cosmic screen of your conscience, even when you're alone and by yourself. I'm guilty. I feel ashamed. And you don't really feel ashamed because you ain't exposed yet. Once you get exposed, I'll tell you how your shame gonna show up then. When you're exposed. See, what this teaching does, there's so much. See, what this teaching does, it exposes the adversary. Let me get that plate. I know it's here. 14. Did I bring it up? Oh. It exposes the adversary. That's what this, he exposes the adversary. That's his mission, come on him, and that's his goal. But it's already declared and set up. Because what he's going to do, talking about Lucifer, he's going to pervert these attributes. You see, and when he perverted, you see, he already knows they're being perverted. You don't. Because you are the one that's been perverted. Now you, your flesh, your theory, your concept, your so-called belief system has to be either A, destroyed or exposed. And you're going to be just like the other angels. Either you're going to follow Lucifer or you're going to go with the man that created Lucifer. That's just the way it is. That means you might have to sacrifice whatever your program is or what you think your program is.
whether it be family, friends, cousins, you know, your job, whatever. You just might have to do that. But I guarantee you, Yahweh will bless you. I promise you that. Mm-hmm. He will bless you beyond blessings. Mm-hmm. You with me so far? Mm-hmm. All right, now, let's read.
Exodus.
I think I'm done with that, God. I just want to declare, you see, that the Gentiles were a group of people separate than the Jews, you see. And the Jew, the first Hebrew, was Abraham, you see. And the word Hebrew means he who comes from the other side of the river. And the river that Abraham crossed was the river Euphrates. He was the first Hebrew. Abraham had two sons, Ishmael and Isaac, but the seed of promise was Isaac. Okay. Here come Isaac, who had a set of twins, Esau and Jacob. You see, and Jacob, you see, was that righteous lineage. You see, we ain't got time to draw it out, but to make a long story short, you see, Jacob had 12 sons.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And those 12 sons make up the sons of Jacob or the children of Israel, because Jacob's name was changed from Jacob to Israel when he wrestled with that angel one night. So now they're called the descendants of Israel or the sons of Jacob. Either one, they're all freaking Hebrews. Mm-hmm. You get the point?
Yeah.
All of them.
Yeah.
All right? Mm-hmm. Now, the promise was made not only to the Jew, but to the Gentile as well. We're going to go into it, but if you read the 24th chapter of Genesis, it talks about how Sarah, because you know now, Ishmael's about 15. And he run around, and listen, when you get that, I mean, you're 15 years old, you can get your wife, you can have some money, you can have some stock. I mean, you're a man. And he know his father Abraham was fat. In other words, he was not broke. He had some long pockets. And he out there flossing around, you know, showing off. I went, you know, like when dad dies, all this is going to belong to me. And Sarah, looking at this dude, said, I don't think so. You think everything going to go to you and not my son?
Yeah.
He says, listen, Abraham, you go and get your woman, your mistress, whatever you want to call her, your concubine, your partner, whatever, your girlfriend, and you tell her and her son to get the hell out of my house. You do it. Now, you know what? She don't want to get him permission to be with her.
Mm-hmm.
But she also told her to tell her to get out of here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Since you did it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? Abraham did not want to do it. Because that's his son.
Right, right.
You see? And listen, he packed a little sack lunch, if you want to call it that. Mm-hmm. Gave him some water. And say, I'm sorry, but the wife say, you gotta go. You follow me? You gotta go. And they take off and go.
Uh-huh.
And listen, we ain't gonna get to it, but the point is, she leaves with her son in the freaking desert.
Mm-hmm.
Thirsty. Mm-hmm. And it was going out there to die. Mm-hmm. We got a pattern. We gotta die. But listen, the woman sees her son about to die. He's thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
You see? And he's getting dehydrated. Mm-hmm. So she said, I can't see the death of my son. What mother would want to see the death of their kid?
Right.
So she goes and buries him. You follow me, under the bushes.
Mm-hmm.
Because, remember, we got a death, we got a burial, we got to have a resurrection. We got a pattern we operate by.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to die. So she buried that and then she walked. The book says, a bow shot. You follow what I'm saying? Well, how far a ball goes, maybe the football field, however strong you are, that's how far it goes.
Mm-hmm.
And she moves on in tears. Her son left his son to die, buried under a bush. But Yahweh is rich in mercy.
Mm-hmm.
He's rich in mercy. And he appeared unto her in her consciousness. Not out of the sky, but in her, where is it at? In her consciousness. In other words, the veil was just elevated.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You see, and as he spoke to her from within, no audible sound, he said, don't worry about the boy. You go back and get that boy. I'm going to bless him just as I blessed the other boy. He made Abraham know that too. Don't worry about Ishmael. I'm going to take care of Ishmael. Abraham was made to know that.
Yeah.
His son, Ishmael, is going to be all right. You know why? Because Yahweh spoke to him.
Yeah.
And he talked to him. And he believed Yahweh. And it was accounted to him for righteousness. Just as he offered up Isaac, guess what? He offered up Ishmael as well.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, come on. He could have said, listen, Sarah, this is my house. I ain't going to say it the way I want. But put it like this, I'll run the show. He ain't going. He could have done that.
Yeah.
But Yahweh appeared unto him. Because there's a promise that was been made.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Yahweh is not slack concerning his promise. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And he sent the boy up. Because there's a purpose. You see? And he went, and Yahweh said, he's going to be all right. And again, and just show him in a figure to my Yahweh, appear to him and tell him what's going to happen to the boy. Mm-hmm. And he's going to make him rich and make him wealthy. You know who some of the wealthiest folks on this earth is?
Yeah.
Those folks in the Middle East. I'm talking about the Iraqis, the Iranians, you know. They don't know how to make money, but they sure have a whole lot of it over there.
Yeah.
And when they come over here, I'm going to tell you that most of them don't work, but they sure know how to make some money. Guess what? Folks who've been here all their life, you know what? You go in there buying their candy, buying their dresses. You can even follow that because they come over here and guess what? They know how to run business.
Yep.
But the point, you get the point. My point is, he blessed both seed, Jew and Gentile.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now, Yahshua, who gets on the cross, died the death of an outcast dog, pour out his spirit in this present kingdom age where you sit. That's why we read Ephesians.
Mm-hmm.
You follow me? Oh man, there's so much.
Mm-hmm.
You see? In the dispensation of the fullness, they're going to gather on all things in heaven and earth, right?
Yeah.
Even in him.
That's right.
You see? Because the Holy Spirit already been poured out in his age.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Paul looked at that thing. This is what he said. You got Ephesians. Pick it up again real quick. But pick up 2 and 1. Because I got to bring you in. My point is, you still got Exodus, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here we are in this present kingdom age. And this is what Paul says. Let's read, please.
Ephesians chapter 2 and 1.
Read.
And you have he quickened.
Now hold it, Doc. When you go back and read that again, where it says you, I want you to hit it. And you have he quickened. Read, please.
Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
And you.
That's us. In this present kingdom has he quickened, has made alive in this age. Read.
Who were dead in trespasses and sins.
Yes, that's us.
Mm-hmm.
We was caught up in the world. We was caught up in the world.
Yeah.
Come on, read please.
Wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world.
In other words, proving the existence and the structure of Satan. No, this is Satan. These are the demons. We walk in the course of this world. So what you think is, whatever that may be, whatever country, whatever continent, whatever city, state, county, whatever, neighborhood, that's you. Whatever you think it is. Even the homeless, they got their own code of ethics as well.
Right.
You see? Read, please.
According to the prince of the power of the air.
According to the prince of the power of the air. That's him.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I got to put this on the board. Remember. You got eternity, right?
Mm-hmm.
You got atmosphere. And you got space. Okay, space, earth, atmosphere, that's the air,
mm-hmm.
You follow me? Eternity. These two emanate from the one, throughout eternity.
just as Elohim come from behind the veil of obscurity, but he abides within the realm of eternity. So he, and then he draws the creation out.
Right.
You see? So you got all of this coming right out of him. You with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
These two, about the creation and him, emanate from him, which is Yahweh. Alright?
Mm-hmm.
So the air, Lucifer, I say it like this, as far as he can get, as he makes his descent from heaven, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's coming on down. He's going to try to come back into heaven, but guess what? He cannot make it. He's going to make a six.
Mm-hmm.
That's all he can do. He's on the veil, but he got to come on. He can't get back in. But he can hang out in your soul, because man made spirit, soul, and body, in the air, and guess what? Just buffet you all he want. Cause you to have all kinds of problems. That's the point that I'm trying to make. Read, please. I got to move. Come on, please. Where you left off?
The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience.
Read on.
Among whom also we all had our deportment in time past in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind.
Read on.
And were by nature the children of wrath, even as others.
Read on.
But Yahweh, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us.
Read on.
Even we were dead in sin.
Read.
But had quickened us together with the Messiah.
I think death, burial, resurrection. Come on, read.
By grace ye are saved.
By grace. What do you mean by grace? These attributes. By grace are you saved. That's why I went and drew the woman with the egg and the seed and gave you the opportunity to take on shape and form in the woman and then come on earth plane. And guess what? Now you have an opportunity to know your creator as you really is. And ask you this. By grace are you saved.
Mm-hmm.
Before you got here.
Mm-hmm.
You are those angels who come down and lost not their first estate and desire to put on. You follow me? Those attributes of Yahshua Messiah and be one with Yahweh in the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
You are not a fallen angel.
Right.
But I ain't got time to draw that out the way I want. That's another lecture. Why? Because a fallen angel, he will not repent. He can't repent. And the founder said that those angels that followed Lucifer out of the garden, out of heaven, it is as if they did not exist. They are not welcome back in to the kingdom of Yahshua Messiah.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Now this is what I'm talking about. 32nd chapter of Exodus. I think I'm going to wrap it up with that if I can.
Exodus 32, 32 and 1.
Now remember, there were three trips in the mountain.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
The first trip, Yahweh told Moses to come up to the mountain. You see, tell the people to gather here. Then you're going to speak to him in 3 days. That's what he said.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do it like this here. All right, three trips in the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
First one, I'm going to speak to you in 3 days.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
And after 3 days, because they got there June 3rd, and on June 6th, Yahweh spoke.
Right.
And he spoke that law down.
Mm-hmm.
All right? He spoke 10 laws from the mountain, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he talked to Moses, and he gave another 603, which makes a total of 613 statutes and judgments.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Right?
You read that in the 19th chapter of Exodus. Then he invited Moses up into the mountain, which you read in the 24th chapter of Exodus.
Right.
And he told him to come up and get the table stone, which is written on which was written with Yahweh's finger.
Mm-hmm.
Alright?
Mm-hmm.
That's the table of stones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Which is the 10th commandment law. Alright? There's 10 laws, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll just do it like this. That's close enough.
Yeah.
You get the point.
Mm-hmm.
So he invites him up to get the table of stones.
Mm-hmm.
And when he gets up there, talking about Moses, Joshua, the son of Nun, invites him up, transforms him to the tabernacle, and show him how the creation came in by the pattern.
Yeah.
You with me so far? You see? Now, when Joshua, the son of Nun, who was, invite him up, goes up with him, he's narrating the Genesis to the man Moses.
Right.
7 6 days of creation, and Yahweh entered his rest, and then for the next 33 days, he received divine specifications on how to build and construct this tabernacle.
Right.
All right? Mm-hmm. Now, while he was up in the mount, this is what I was after the whole time. I shouldn't have talked so long to get to this right. These carnal minded people who are no longer down here in Egypt, oh, did they have a party? They was partying out here. You hear what I say?
Yeah.
And Moses had come back, you know what they said? They built the golden calf and said, let this be the Elohim that brought us up out of the land of Egypt. In other words, they corrupted Elohim and they created an idol within their consciousness.
Yeah.
And guess what? Aaron was a party to it because he was in charge.
Right.
He said, you have a problem? Aaron hurt? Y'all go talk to them. Now read, you gotta move. Watch this.
And when the people saw that Moses is delayed to come down out of the mount, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron.
Now here comes this carnal mind.
And said unto him,
this egotistical, misdirected personality. They're gonna approach Aaron. Who's down there talking to Pharaoh on their stand? Read, please.
Up, make us deities.
We
shall go before us.
Hey, make us a god. Because Moses ain't coming back. We need a god. We got to worship something. Yeah. Read, please.
For this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we know not what is become of him.
Now, what he said first, what the people said first, that all the little Moses, you go talk to Yahweh.
Right.
Don't let him talk to us that way. No. And all that he said, we will do.
Yeah.
That was the marriage.
Yeah.
I do, we will do.
Yeah.
All of Israel was his bride.
Yes,
Moses was cool with that. Read, please.
And Aaron said unto them,
read.
Break out the golden ear, which are in the ears of your wives.
Read on.
And of your sons.
Come on.
And of your daughters, and bring them unto me.
Come on.
And all the people break off the golden earrings, which were in the ears.
Come on.
And brought them unto Aaron.
Read on.
And he received them at their hand.
Read on.
And fashioned it in a mold, and he made of it a molten calf.
Yeah, real.
And they said, these be thy Elohim. These be thy Elohim. O Israel.
Read.
Which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt.
Come on.
And when Aaron saw it, he built an altar before it.
Read.
And Aaron made proclamation. And
read.
Said,
come on.
Tomorrow is a feast to Yahweh. And they rose up early on the morrow.
Read.
And offered burnt offerings. And brought peace offerings.
Read.
And the people sat down to eat and drink.
Listen.
And rose up to now therefore, let me alone.
Read.
That my wrath may wax hot against me.
Because look, they no worse. They betraying me now. Read, please. And I'm going to give them everything. And they're mistreating me. Read.
And that I may consume them.
Read on.
I will make of thee a great nation.
Now what? Come on, read. Now listen. I'm going to consume these stiff-necked, uncircumcised Jews. Unappreciative. Come on, read.
And Moses besought y'all.
No, Moses. Wait. Come on, y'all. Don't be like that, y'all. Come on now. You ain't giving. You done brought the people out of the land. Don't be like that. Come on, read.
Yahweh is Elohim. It said, Yahweh,
read on.
Undo thy wrath, wax hot.
So Moses said, come on, Yahweh, why you act like that? Come on.
which thou hast brought forth out of the land of Egypt.
Now you done brought us up out of here. Come on, read on.
With great power and with an...
Hey, I ain't never seen nothing like it. You done killed all them folks, poured out all of the plague. You guess what? You done opened up the sea when it walked through, and you're feeding us too? Come on, read.
Wherefore should the Egyptians speak and say?
In other words, come on, man. Don't make us look bad. If you kill us all out there, they should have kept their butt down here when they were saying, building my treasure city. Don't give them that. This is Moses talking to y'all. Well, come on, read.
For mischief did he bring them out.
Oh, read on.
To slay them in the mountains and to consume them from the face of the earth.
In other words, that's what the Gentiles will say about them. Read, please.
Turn from thy fierce wrath and reconsider of this evil against thy people.
Come on, look at this. This is Moses talking to Yahweh, who is pissed off. He's angry. Because he just spoke the law, and these folks acting a complete damn fool. Talking about let this be to Yahweh. Yeah. So Moses said, come on, Yahweh, reconsider your position on this thing. Come on, read.
Remember Abraham.
Look, wait. Come on, man. He created Abraham, and he talked to Abraham. So now Moses, who ain't never seen Abraham, said, remember Abraham? Come on, read on.
Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel?
Come on, you set this thing up, Carl. You've been talking about this all the time. It's been 400 years. 430 years, to be exact. Come on, read.
Thy servants, to whom thou swearest by thine own self, and saidest unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars.
In other words, come on, man, you ain't slack concerning your promise. You kill them all. Come on, what's going to happen then? Come on.
And all this land.
You know Yahweh is just even kill them and raise them back up if you choose to, but you get the point. Read on.
And all this land that I have spoken of will I give unto you.
Come on.
Your seed.
Read on.
And they shall inherit it forever.
In other words, you told Abraham all this stuff. You're going to kill them all? Come on, man. But don't be like that. Read.
And Yahweh reconsidered of the evil which he thought to do unto his people.
It looked like he reconsidered. Yahweh is not slack concerning his promise. That was in the scripture lesson. Read, please.
And Moses turned and went down from the mountain.
Now he head on down. Now watch this. Read on.
And the two tables of the testimony were in his hand.
So he's coming on down with the table of stones. Come on, read.
The tables were written on both their sides. On the one side and on the other were they written.
In other words, Father, Word, and Holy Spirit, read all on one side, seven on the other side, representing the 7 days of creation. We got a pattern. There's seven steps to this tabernacle. You see, you got the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit represent the most holy place, the holy place in court round about, which is to write three laws on one side. You got the gate being one, the altar of sin sacrifice being two, the laver where the washing takes place is three, the door is four where the cup of holy oil is at the door, the holy place and all of its contents, the seven branch golden lampstand, the table of shewbread, and the altar of incense. That is the fifth step in your pattern. Then you got your second departmental veil, which is your sixth step. And then, of course, you got the Ark of the Covenant of the Most Holy Place, which is seven. You got three, and you got seven. So write it like this. Read. Come on.
And the tables were the work of Elohim.
Read on.
And the writing was the writing of Elohim.
Come on.
Graven upon the tables.
Read on.
And when Joshua heard the noise of the people...
Now, wait. Here's Joshua and Moses in the mountain. How come Moses couldn't hear the noise of the people?
There you go.
I mean, it's not like they wasn't up there together. They walked up there together.
Right. Yeah.
But he heard the noise of the people.
Yeah.
Yeah. You see? Oh, man, there's so much. I can tell you what, but just read on.
He said unto Moses, there's a noise of war in the camp.
Hey, that's something going on down in the camp, man. Read on.
And he said, it is not the voice of them that shout for mastery.
In other words, they ain't going to be happy to see you. I tell you that right now. You see? Because they are just acting a complete fool. Read on, please.
Neither is it the voice of them that cry for being overcome.
Read on.
But the noise of them that sing do I hear.
In other words, it is this egotistical, misdirected personality, this corrupt mind, mortality, they don't have a clue what immortality is all about, or where it's going to come from, or how it operates, what heaven is, and where it is, and how it operates. Who created it, and how he operates.
Where they come, they have no clue. They didn't know their origin, because even Moses didn't know his origin until Yahweh showed him. This is the kind of people we're dealing with, folks. These folks in the churches are just like these folks right here. You see? And want to fight about it, too. Read, please.
And it came to pass as soon as he came nigh unto the camp.
Come on.
That he saw the calf, and the dancing, and Moses. Anger grew hot, and he cast the tables out of his hands.
Wait. Here's Yahweh. Moses talking to Yahweh. Said, man, come on, man. Don't be like that. Reconsider your position. Now, here Moses coming down the mountain. He's so mad, he done broke the doggone table stone that Yahweh wrote with his finger. Now he understands how Yahweh felt the way he felt. You see? Read, please.
He cast the tables out of his hands.
And let me tell you something. That's how we feel when folks come here and they leave. It's the truth. And they leave. Don't leave. See, don't leave the hand that feeds you. Don't never forsake Yahweh for the world. And let me tell you something, the world. The adversary would do whatever it takes to mess your mind up to have you doing everything but what you should be doing. Mm-hmm. And that is seeking him. Mm-hmm. And when you seek him and you will get rest. Mm-hmm. That's the whole idea. Let's read.
And he took the calf which they had made.
Read.
And burnt it in the fire.
Read on.
And ground it to powder.
Read on.
And strewed it upon the water.
And threw it on the water. Come on.
And made the children of Israel drink it.
And they're drinking.
And Moses said unto Aaron.
Read.
What did this people unto thee?
Now that's good enough. I can draw this out a little bit, but I ain't got time. Here I go over to 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 5th chapter. Yeah. Oh, there's so much. I'm only got about 3 minutes. We're going to get out here at 9:30. I ain't going to run over. Okay, I've talked enough. 5 and 16. Wherefore, henceforth, read on.
Wherefore, henceforth, yes. know we no man after the flesh. Yea, though we have known the Messiah after the flesh.
Read on.
Yet now henceforth know we him no more.
Don't even know him after the flesh no more. Read on.
Therefore, if any man be in the Messiah.
If you be in Yahshua's Messiah, not this physical body, but this resurrected body. Read on.
He is a new creature.
You are a new creature. Read on.
Old things are passed away.
Mortality hath put on immortality. Corruption hath put on incorruption. There's no more you, there's no more me, there's no more male, female, no bond of free. That bad attitude you had has gone. You have some peace. You can tolerate this stiff-necked, egotistical, misdirected personality, and you have some doggone mercy. Let's read on, please. Come on.
Behold, all things
are become new. Behold means to look. He says, all things are become new. In other words, when I was 26, I tell you to sit down. If you don't sit down, I'll whoop your little butt. You know what I mean? Now, I might talk to you and say, listen, I don't want to have to beat your butt. But if you don't sit down, then you know I'm going to put some heat on your butt. Now, you're going to sit down or not? I'm giving you a chance. You get my point? But, hey, boom, bam, tear your tail up. Read on, please.
And all things are of Yahweh.
Read.
Who hath reconciled us to himself.
Come on.
By Yahshua the Messiah.
In other words, by him, by his death, burial, and resurrection. We've all been reconciled because now he is sitting on the right hand of the Father. Listen, clothed upon with divine intelligence. Wisdom and knowledge, beauty, love, and justice, foundation, power, and strength. Read, please.
And hath given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
In other words, a minister is a servant. That's what ministry is by definition.
Yes.
We are servants. We serve one another. When I sit down there, you are serving me. Title Dean don't mean nothing. Not a damn thing. And when you have that title, guess right. Guess what? Some folks make it bigger than what it is. And that's their carnality.
Right.
Because at the end of the day, I use Charmin like you use Charmin. And they use Charmin like you use Charmin as well. You follow me? And when you get a certain age, guess what? You might have a little diarrhea too. Uncontrollably. You get the point?
Yeah.
D. Read on, please.
To wit.
Read.
That Yahweh was in the Messiah.
That Yahweh was in the Messiah. I said earlier that Yahweh Elohim is the mind of Yahshua Messiah. Yahweh is the mind. The Word was made flesh. Come on.
Reconciling the world unto himself.
Read.
Not imputing their trespasses.
So therefore, in this present kingdom, it is the spiritual kingdom on earth. A spiritual symbol. The body of Yahshua. Not the physical body, but the spirit body. The Holy Spirit through faith, if you believe the report. Mm-hmm. You see? Then Pentecost has come unto you. Mm-hmm. And you know and you understand that you're being governed and ruled by spirit law, which is Yahweh himself. Let's read, please.
And hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation.
Now listen, there's a six in his age. Kingdom and immortality, you have come unto immortality in this age right here. Because what we're talking about is him who only hath immortality, which is Yahshua Messiah. Him being formed in you is immortality. And when he's formed in you, that old man is passed away, and that new man, which is Yahshua Messiah, is formed in you. Mm-hmm. Now, you may wear the title of Jack, Joe, John while you're on the earth, but in reality, you are a son of Yahweh, mm-hmm. posing as Joe Williams. Mm-hmm. You see, Jack Jones, mm-hmm. Muhammad Ali. Well, you get my point? Mm-hmm. But watch. You see, you're posing as, in the but you know what? Folks don't know. As a fact, the book said, if you don't watch it, you might be entertaining angels on a nowhere. Mm-hmm. But the real, because I'm posing as the adversary. Yeah. As that corrupt, egotistical, misdirected personality. But when you start talking, who you really dealing with is Yahweh himself. Mm-hmm. In the personality of Joe Williams, who is Yahshua Messiah. You see, hidden in the mystery.
Right. Right.
Hallelujah, folks.
All right.
Brother, truly thank the Father for allowing us to hold class this evening, and we hold classes every Tuesday and Friday from 7:30 to 9:30, Sunday mornings from 11 to 1. And the fourth Sunday of the month, we have a Spanish class from 9:30 in the morning to 10:45. So come back again and study with us. Bring your friends and all your enemies, and if you have any donations, I can take them. And stand for the doxology. Now to him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise Elohim, our Savior, to Yahshua the Messiah, our Sovereign, belong glory, majesty, dominion, and power both before all time, now and ever. Let us all say,
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Great class, Jim. Great class.
Thank you, boss. Appreciate it. You don't know how hard I try not to come to class.
What you mean?
No. I said,
get up and go.
Yeah.